That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
So that last play gives him a little more space now. Here's first and 10 at the 16-yard line. From the gun, Rich. Short throw hauled in by Croft. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. On first down, Knox. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down. The numbers for him from a week ago, 15 carries, 66 yards.
And well-liked by his teammates. In fact, I got on good authority, even though I'm not an investigative reporter, that in their team meeting this week, the offensive line stood up and said, "Coach, we've got to have better yardage for this guy. He's number 9 in the league. He's got to be in the top 3 before the season's over. Let's run the ball."
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. On first and 10, Rich. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of this tight end, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. To throw on second down, Rich. Short throw hauled in by Croft. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. Play number 9 set to come here on the drive on 3rd and 2. Off the play fake, Rich. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on 3rd down. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line. They'll set up a throw. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete. Here they come, second and 10 now from the 10. Hurts. He'll find the Heisman Trophy winner, Devontae Smith. So 3rd and 2, and I count 6 defensive backs out there. Throwing is Hurts. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down. And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. No score after 1 on EA Sports. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. They've been playing the field position game thus far. No score, second quarter as they come up on 1st and 10. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. They run the counter. Knox, and across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. He's across midfield with a 49-yard line. Off the bootleg, Rich. Short throw hauled in by Croft. And he is going to have a Jets first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on 3rd and 2.
Good protection there on 3rd down. This is just a simple flip to his tight end outside the numbers. He's able to haul it in and pick up the 1st down.
They go play action here on 1st down. Flush to his right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Rich. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more.
Because his primary job is defending against the pass, you don't often see a cornerback making tackles in the backfield. But he's playing run all the way here.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on 3rd down. Looking to throw, Rich. Short throw hauled in by Croft. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Now the Jets will call another field goal unit here. From the left hash, this from 37. This is up and good from Pinheiro. And the Jets hit the board first. It's 3-0. So they do get 3 points, but that's now 3 drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
And now we spotlight the Jets defense. And let's take a peek at some of the defensive effort here that's helped them get this first half lead.
Yeah, I remember in school, we used to have a term for it, break on it. When you see the ball in the air, when you see a receiver make the cut, and you anticipate it, break on the football, get there, make a play. And we've seen a lot of that so far in this game.
Coverage has been excellent. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive in the midst of, well, let's just say a not-so-rosy losing streak. They've got the open week, though, coming up next weekend, so you have to figure this to be a game that they dearly love to have.
Oh, indeed. They have to have this one because that's something positive to take with you when you go away for a few days and it actually releases your mind. If they lose this one, that mindset is cluttered the entire time they're away. And they've got to scramble to get back in sync when they start playing again.
So now a fresh set of downs, 1st and 10 after roughing the passer. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And the Jets. Yeah. Bucks are going to take possession here at their own 33. Well, CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll try the left side. Knox. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. 49 yards rushing for him now to this point. There are times on carries like that where he looks a little bit older than his rookie status.
How many times have we talked when we've gone out to dinner about how precocious these youngsters are that come into the NFL now? They play at a higher level at a younger age. The stars aren't quite in their eyes as much as it used to be, huh?
And look like some movement there. Let's get the call. And that's on big Mekhi Becton, first round pick in 2020. The false start backs him up five, first and 15. And he'll give it here to his running back. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. To throw on second down, Rich. He'll look downfield for Humphreys, and it is incomplete. I had a defender running right with him, and now it's third down. Throwing on third and long, Rich. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Brandon Graham, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
Here's Braden Mann now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And looking up into the sun, he's able to make the fair catch inside the 20-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Jalen Hurts in this offense trotting back out. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press. You'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Here's Hurts to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Hurts sets up to throw it. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. Hurts trying to hurry up the offense. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Short, they'll try and pick it up through the air, eluding the pressure right. And Hurts able to show off some of that elusiveness as he slides to the ground there and in the process picks up the first down. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. But first down, Hurts. And That's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Going deep here for Watkins. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. A big play there just before halftime.
This offense has been slow to get started, but that play will certainly give them a little bit of life. Maybe the late wake-up call that they had been seeking.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. They're going to look to throw. Rolling to his right. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jalen Hurts, touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Eagles have taken the lead. So that really an almost perfect drive as they chew up some clock and wind up scoring late in this first half.
And remember, they've got a chance to double dip here because they're going to get the ball first to start the third quarter. So they potentially could go up 2 scores before the other guys get a chance to do anything.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. That time, a 9-play drive. And in the end, it's capped off by a 7-yard run. Now, after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Here's Humphreys. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Things definitely getting interesting around the NFL as we begin the month of December. So let's get right to it. We'll begin in South Florida. It's not retirees or snowbirds, but it is New Yorkers traveling down to the Sunshine State. The Giants in town to take on Miami. And it's the Giants who are out in front. Sterling Shepard, a touchdown reception. From there, we move to H-Town to check on the Texans at home at NRG Stadium. And they have the lead in that one over the visiting Indianapolis Colts. Deshaun Watson has thrown a touchdown pass. Lastly, let's motor up to the Motor City. See what's happening with the Lions at home at Ford Field. And it's the visiting Minnesota Vikings who are out in front. Dalvin Cook has scored a touchdown there. Meanwhile, in our game, not a lot of offense to go around. 7-3 is our score. Will we see things open up in the second half? To find out, we get it back to our guys in the booth, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. The Eagles ready to go on offense to begin this third quarter. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes,
You're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. They'll look to throw. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Now that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a three and out there, and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Quick slant here to Smith. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. He'll look to throw. That'll be dumped off to Gainwell. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Back to throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a third and 3. And they'll try and run for it with Gainwell. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll drop to throw. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. They get this to Smith on the jet sweep. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Try and run the option to pick it up. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
Well, he's had success running the football in this one, and that's undeniable, but that time the defense was on to it.
And partner, I think the more you see a play like this, the more they're able to diagnose it quicker and easier for them to defend it. I think you have to dress it up a little bit and show maybe some different formations and looks.
The field goal unit's going to stay put on the sideline. They're going to go on fourth down here. He'll drop to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16.
And Charles, with that completion, I'm told that puts him now over 3,000 yards passing on the campaign.
And Brandon, I think we have to start to think about where we are in the season, because right now, 4,000 is not out of the question. I think a big game or two, he's certainly capable of getting that done.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. His throw caught at about the 5.
And the Eagles are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. Gainwell,
and he's in for an Eagles touchdown.
Kenneth Gainwell.
his sixth touchdown of the season.
And the Eagles take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a two-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Taken at the goal line.
And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call. So the hold on special teams backs him up all the way inside the 15 to start. Throwing on first down, Rich, and able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. On second down now, Knox. Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Now as we look down, it appears we've got a jet shaking up on the play. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw, Rich. Toward the sideline, did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Gavin, guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Looking to throw. Rich, back to the same target. Campbell.
Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back.
Coming up on a 2nd and 6.
Back to throw. Rich. Gets this to Campbell out on the right side. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Back to throw again. Campbell making the catch. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
Going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
They'll look to throw again. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. They'll keep it on the ground. Knox. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. 68 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries. This is a very impressive drive, especially when you consider where they started from to now be set up first and goal.
Yeah, and some nice running right there. That's what got him the first down. But at this point, I suggest open it.
And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Second touchdown on the season. And the Jets have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Big play coming now for the Jets as they'll set up to go for two. They'll try and run it here. And he will get into the end zone as a two-point conversion is successful. And the lead is down to a field goal here in the fourth. I guess the coach looked at the two-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a three-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call. And he felt good about what he had for a two-point conversion. And now they're only down three and feeling great about themselves.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up. Send this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. They've been rolling the last couple of drives, each ending in touchdowns. So this game is flipped. They were down. Now they're up with the football. We'll see how they handle it.
Can we get a spy on the headset now between the head coach and offensive coordinator? Because they've been in attack mode. Had to get back into the game. Now they have the lead. Do you stay on the attack, or do you dial it back a little bit to try and protect this lead?
Well, my cop-out answer would be somewhere in the middle. I think it's going to be a fine line, is it not?
I think you're exactly right, but I do think if they can stay aggressive and keep them on their heels, they'll be best served that way.
On second down, Gainwell looking for space. A very tough run, but for a short gain out near the 32. The Eagles on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Back to throw here. McConley's got it over the middle. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And I think they're defensively, they were so intent on stopping the run that they kind of got caught out of position. This is just a simple pitch and catch for a first down.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. Flushed out right. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. They'll look to throw here. Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line.
Well, that takeaway, partner, right there, that's a combination of coaching, execution, and absolute belief. Because a lot of guys will look at the scoreboard and go, this thing's pretty well done. But they still thought to themselves, if we can make a play, we give our teammates a chance to win it. And that's exactly what they did.
Following the fumble recovery, Rich. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Akron gain of two.
Second down and eight.
Now a give, right side. Knox. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. They'll keep it on the ground. Knox. And all the way down inside the five to the four. 85 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
Well, sometimes, Brandon, it's just not a secret to how things get done. He's been running well all game long, and they continue to rely on him in this key situation.
They told us they were going to rely on him. They have. He comes through there, a big third down conversion. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Looking to throw. Rich. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Alex Singleton. And the Eagles are going to take over at their own 13-yard line. Those INTs all sting when you throw one in the red zone. I think especially as a rookie, maybe it stings a little bit more.
I think what you're saying is they don't all count the same, do they? Right? Interceptions in the red zone that you've given up points now, those are precious, so you have to learn from those and in a hurry.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 13. They start the drive here with Gainwell. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside.
Second down and three.
They go play action with Hurts. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Carl Lawson racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
We've seen him escape similar situations earlier in the game and get away from pretty good yardage. And that time, they get him down.
Yeah, they've had enough evidence that he can get away and run for good yardage, haven't they? That time it felt like, okay, enough of this. Let's play it the right way and get him on the ground before he does any damage.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
The Eagles send out their punter now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. Less than two to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Back to throw. This is caught. Touchdown. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Jets are going to retake the lead. Those are the types of plays in these moments they were hoping for from this young rookie, able to put him up here in the fourth quarter.
How about the kid? You just mentioned it. The fourth quarter. This is when you have to make those winning plays. That's what he just did. Doesn't ensure anything, but he certainly gave his team a heck of a chance, didn't he?
Eddie Pinheiro now for the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. So they only needed three plays on that drive. And it's finished off by a New York Jets touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Hurts and the Eagles now. Down by four, 1:06 to play. A four straight defeat looming on the horizon, barring a comeback here as they've got it with a first down. He's back to throw. Out to his left. Evades the tackler and now some space. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Back to throw. Finding Watkins. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. He'll look to throw. And this one complete to Smith. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Well, this defense has been physical all game long, and it certainly looks like they're not going to back off and make things any easier. They want to keep making life miserable for the receivers all the way to the end.
To throw once more on second and 10, Hurts. He's got the hookup with Conley. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. Again, he'll drop to throw. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Down four late. Got to go for it here on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Well, Charles, this one's going to be hard to digest. You take the lead into the fourth quarter, lose that lead. Maybe they felt like they let this one slip away a little bit.
They will definitely feel like that, because when you have a lead in the fourth quarter, all you talk about doing is finishing and closing a game out. But when you flip it over, how about that? Making the comeback and then finishing the game, sealing it on defense, they will feel jubilant in their locker room.
So for the Jets, the streak continues as they push their mark to a perfect 12-0 now on the year. And they'll get another home date next week as the Saints will come to town. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, it's unfortunately more of the same as they'll fall to 3-10 on the year. And they'll get the extra week to think about this one as they return to action in 2 weeks' time. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
I'm ready for more.
If you fight up, I'm fired up. Don't run from rap.
1, 2, 3. Hey.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. Game time. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I just got 20, I'm running on empty. This mobile that came from my money is silly. I feel the envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
I'm ready for more.
Whole squad in the field, yeah, we
tell them I'm ready for more.
I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more.
Tell them I'm ready for more.
I'm ready for war.
Tell them I'm ready for war.
I'm ready for more.
Tell them I'm ready for more.
I'm ready for war.
Tell them I'm ready for war.
Kick a punt, then I make them catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I never press. I just made a mess. 50-yard TD with the winning catch. Oh no. I just made a mess. When they throw the pass, all I know is catch. I just want the bag, like a Nike check. All I know is flex. Bust the defense open, running through some. I don't know no plays on the field, I just free from. Caught it with the left, but I'm better with my right arm. When they call blitz, hit stick, don't mean no harm. Oh no, oh man, I just made a mess. When I ran it, ain't no stopping, oh, never rest. Down, say a hunt, kick a punt, then I make them catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'll never press. I just made a mess. 50-yard TD with the winning catch. Oh, no. So I make them clap it up. Clap, clap, clap it up. Clap, clap. Now clap it up. No, down and break. Dirty on the field. Make a mess and then I make them clean it up.
Clean, clean.
Clean it up.
Clean, clean.
On the field is not a drill. $50 million deals. Yeah, we get the Caffarel. I make it thunder storm for real. Real baller, first string. Gotta do it for the team. Bust so hard, I call fatigue. Running yards is out to lead. Oh no, oh man, I just made a mess. When I run it, ain't no stopping. Oh, never rest. Down, say a hut, kick a punt. Then I make them catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'll never press. I just made a mess. 50-yard TD with the winning catch. Oh, no.